Sharks are too scared. If you are free soon, could we talk?
UC'll never crush the fleet. They'd have to catch us first.
I've got what you need. For a price.
Yeah?
Well, well. Neva's new hotshot. I knew you'd find your way back to my little corner of the key. Everyone always does. Take a look around, genius. And don't tell me you've never laid eyes on a gun before. But just in case, I need to spell it out for you. The merch I carry is known as weapons and ammunition. Hey, if you want to pour credits into my pocket, you won't hear any arguments from me. I carry most of the standard hardware. You know, kinetics, electromags, energy. Even a few explosives. Occasionally, I stock a few smuggled items. Basically, the stuff SysDev doesn't want you to play with. Just don't screw me over, or I'll be inclined to give you a free demo. With your head as the target. We all have trust issues here. A little advice, Sadiqi? The fleet's trust can't be bought. You earn it. You bleed for the fleet bleeds for you. Pure and simple. Anyone who says otherwise is either lying or getting ready to stab you in the back. Please, I don't need your concern. All I care about is separating you from your credits. So let's leave our professional relationship at that, all right? Whatever you need, as long as you can afford it.
Oh, bye, I guess.
Every captain here has earned their stripes, leading for the fleet.
Smuggling beats a real job any day.
Need something?
If you want to stay under the radar, I've got just the thing.
Start something? Because I'll finish it.
I heard Isla's sister is some hardcore person.
It would seem that...
So there I am. You see security on my tail, and my graph drive just chokes. And you know what I find back there? The fattest leech I've ever seen. One nearly got me dusted.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gail Dunnigan of SSNN, and this is Galact Talk. My guest tonight is one of the most notorious criminals in the settled systems. His ruthlessness and desire for wealth has landed him squarely at the top of the wanted list for every major law enforcement. I am, of course, speaking of the self-appointed leader of the Crimson Fleet himself, Jasper Crix. Good evening, Mr. Crix.
Good evening, Gail.
jumped to what appears to be an abandoned mining facility isn't exactly what I'd call an invitation.
Well, I'm sure you're not surprised that your request for an interview would come with some very specific conditions.
Frankly, I was a bit surprised to receive any type of response at all. Would you mind telling me why you decided to do this interview?
Because there comes a time in every pirate's life where they have to make an extremely important decision. Do they take a leap and become one of the most legendary pirates in history? Or do they simply sputter on, subsisting on freighters and deep space privateers?
So are we to assume that you are taking the leap? That Jasper Crix is moving on to bigger and better things in his life?
That's spot on, Gale. That's exactly why you're here.
Interesting. Well then, would you mind sharing with us exactly what your particular leap entails?
In due time. There's no rush. In fact, I'd say we have at least 12 hours before the authorities trace this broadcast. Plenty of time to discuss whatever you like.
Oh. All right then. Perhaps the best place to start this interview would be at the beginning of your career.
Please, proceed.
Please tell me you're here to help.
Not to try and steal my ship.
Yeah, well, if you want to keep that badge, then don't get any ideas. This old girl and I have been through a lot together. I was tracking a crew of outlaws that's been preying on merchant ships. Bastards got the drop on me. I ran them off, but
they got a few good hits in.
As you can see, I ain't in much shape to make repairs. I'll be fine once the pain medication kicks in. The priority right now is the ship. Can't do my job without it. Just patch her up enough to get to Hopetown. The rest can get fixed up there. Don't need to ask for that, I'd have helped you anyway. Since you're new, here's a lesson for you. Rangers look out for each other. Always.
Never hurts to have reliable friends. Can we speak for a moment?
Thanks. That should get me home. Good. There aren't many of us out there. So it makes all our lives easier when we can help each other out. Now let's talk about those outlaw ships. They were pretty beat up, so I don't think they got real far. But if they make it back to their hideout, I might never find them again. We can't let that happen. Light armaments, not too fast. Pilots are gifted amateurs, but still amateurs. You'll be outnumbered, but they'll be damaged, which should even things up for you. You're a Freestar Ranger deputy. You don't pick and choose what parts of the job you want to do. Carrying that badge means you're always on duty, and when the people of the Freestar Collective are in danger, you protect them. Those bandits were headed for Miatha. Now get back in your cockpit and get to work.
Thank you.
Chris, you could help us out. Or we can just dust your ship. Sorry. That's not on the menu.
Open fire! Fire!
If you are free soon, could we talk?
It has been a relief to be honest with you about my past. I appreciate your willingness to listen. But talking about this, remembering all those years, has brought back some unsettling memories. Thank you. That means a great deal to me. I have told you that I spent many years coordinating with smugglers along the edges of the settled systems. There were men and women I worked alongside closely. And over time, I established relationships. They were not of the promised, but I considered them friends. It describes the people of House Varun. We who have been promised to serve the Great Serpent now and forever. In exchange, he promises to care for us when he returns to his domain. Yes, very. It was not what I was expecting. You must understand. I was raised to believe that those who do not follow the Great Serpent do not matter. Or they are lost. Their fate is fixed and grim. And yet here were these men and women with hopes and dreams, delights and aversions. It felt like a small betrayal of my people, of House Varun, but I cared for my friends. And then I lost them. Not something I have much experience with. It was so sudden. We had met on a remote planet to transfer cargo, and zealots appeared in force, seemingly out of nowhere. There was barely time to react. So many were cut down immediately. I believe my years of training saved me, got me moving when others faltered. I retreated to my ship immediately. But I left them all behind. Aaron Bascom and Jada Wong. They were my friends, and I abandoned them. And in the years since, I have never looked for them. No, maybe. I don't know. It all happened so fast, and I've had so much time since then to replay it in my head. Wonder if I should have done things differently. In my time getting to know you, I have thought more and more of all this. How little sense it all made, how I never really knew what happened or what became of my friends. My connection to you has reminded me what it means to trust someone, to be there for them. And I can no longer live with not knowing. I need to finally pursue this. I would like you with me when I do. I do not know what we will find, but I know it will be easier with you at my side. Thank you. That is... I'm sorry. I am not used to someone being so considerate on my behalf. I am not sure where they might be now, but I believe we should begin the search in Aquila City. That is where I last saw Aaron Bascom. wish we had more time to explore.